Let's begin standing with our feet right underneath of our hips. Feeling nice and tall. Let's rock forward and back a little bit. So I'm rocking onto my toes and my heels. Toes, heels, slight bend in my knees. Just waking up the body. Find stillness. Close your eyes a moment. Feel the body sway in all the different directions and notice how instinctively you do not fall over. So as you're swaying from side to side, I want you to think of lifting up the quads, lifting up the kneecaps. So we're not sucking our kneecaps back, we're lifting the front of the quads. Our lower belly is lifting up, so it's as if we're pulling up the front of the pubic bone and our tailbone drops. My lower belly into my upper abs are activated. My chest is open, my shoulders are down, pressed down the back, creating space between my ears. My arms are down by my side. My ears are right over my shoulder, so stick your chin out a little. Now tuck your chin like you're doing like a chicken head. Stick your chin out, tuck your head. Find that center where your ears feel like they're right over the shoulders. Try to minimize the swaying. Find stillness. Breathe through the nose, out through the mouth. And open your eyes. Let's reach our arms out to the side. Let's bring our right hand to our right hip. Let's just lean on over to that right side. So my hand is still out to the side. And lift up. Switch arms, left hand comes to hip, my right hand just right out to the side, pressing into the hip as I lean over. And up. Now, right hand comes to the hip, arm comes up overhead, press and lean. Exhale, up and over, hip, arm comes up, press and lean. Exhale, come center. Let's bend our knees as we scoop our arms in. Straighten our legs as we reach our arms up. Bend and scoop, straighten and up. How fluid can you make this? Get a nice little bounce to it. You can go at your own rhythm. Pretend you're on a trampoline in slow motion. Good. And find stillness. Straighten those legs. Let's tuck the chin into the chest. Roll down. Keep a bend in your knees. Nod the head yes, shake the head no, wiggle the shoulders. Continue wiggling the shoulders as you keep the knees bent and you roll up through the spine one vertebrae at a time. Let's do that again. Tuck the chin, rolling down through the spine. Once you hit bottom, start wiggling through the chest and the shoulders. Bend the knees deep as you continue that movement all the way up. Do that one more time, chin to the chest, rolling down, hands hit the floor, knees are bent, move through the shoulders and the neck as you walk the body up. Good. Let's lower our right ear to our right shoulder. Let's go ahead and reach that left arm behind the back. Grab it with your right hand and give it a gentle pull, increasing the stretch in the side of the neck. And release the arms. Lift the head up and over to the other side. Right hand goes behind my back as I grab it with the left, giving it a gentle pull, increasing the stretch in the side of the neck. Relax the jaw. Release the arms, lift the head up. Let's drop the chin into the chest, rock our head over to the right, and smoothly over to the left, over to the right, and over to the left. And find center, head comes back up on top of the spine. Let's bring our legs out to a second position. So my toes are at a diagonal, my knees are going right over my toes. Let's take some bends. straighten, bend, and straighten. Use your hands to make sure your knees are pressing out at a diagonal. You're opening up your inner thighs. However, we don't want this scenario, and we don't want this scenario. We want to find a nice center, like my tailbone is dropping straight down. My knees are going at a diagonal. You might not be able to go that deep. That's okay. Just waking up those legs. A couple more. Good. And straighten. Let's lift our right heel and bend the knee into it. Lift up, lower the heel. Left heel lifts, bend into it, straighten, and down. This might be a little hard because it's also a strength factor. So lifting that right heel, bending into it, pulling up, lowering the heel. Left heel lifts, bend into it, pull it up, lower the heel. One more time, each side up, and press, and pull, and lower. Lift, and press, and pull, and lower. Bend the knees, straighten the knees. Bend the knees, straighten the knees. Wiggle the hips. Make little circles. No one's watching, so you can do whatever you want. Good, find stillness. Tuck the chin to the chest, rolling the body down. Let's walk our hands forward just enough where the weight is in our hands, but also in our feet. So it's, again, that wide leg dog down pose. Wide leg. Down dog pose, yeah. Feel a stretch in the back of your legs. Relax the head. Walk the hands back, so now your hips are centered over in between your feet. Shift the hips right and left. Find center, walk the hands out again. And bring them in. Let's shift the hips right and left. Walk your hands over to the right foot. So find center with your hips. Walk your hands over to the right. And walk your hands to center, over to the left. And walk your hands center. Nod the head yes. Shake the head no. Take a bend in the knees, roll up through the spine, one vertebrae at a time. If you need to walk your hands up against your body, totally fine, whatever makes your low back feel safe. Standing up nice and tall, we're gonna turn all of our body over to the right side of the room. So both toes facing the right side of the room, both knees facing, everything facing right side. Arms are out in front of you. I'm gonna bend into that front leg and lift the heel of our back leg. If you want, you can put your hands on your hips, but I like this because it makes everything go in that direction. So let's try that again. Everything is pointing to the right. I'm gonna bend into my front foot so it has most of my weight, so I can adjust my back foot behind me and lift the heel off the ground. So I'm feeling it stretch right in the front of my left leg. I also feel a lot of work in my right quad right now. Hang out here, breathe. And when you're ready, we're going to try to bring that left leg into meet the right. So I'm going to shift my weight forward, bring that left foot into meet the right. Reach the arms up. Arms come down, bend the knees. Now we're going to shift our weight onto that right leg so we can slide this left leg back behind us into that lunge again. Hold, breathe. This is a lot of stretch in this leg and a lot of work. You're ready, inhale, shift your weight onto that right leg and bring that left leg in. Straighten the arms up and bring the arms down. Good job. That was hard, but I wanted you to feel the stretch we're working on. Facing the left side of the room. Separate the feet. Now both toes are facing the left side of the room. Hands go around in front of me, shifting my weight over the left foot. Lifting my right leg up so I can slide it back, lifting the heel. Again, stretch in that right leg in the front, and your left quad is working. Hold here. Breathe. our weight onto our left leg as we bring in that right leg to meet the left. Arms come up, arms come down. Bring the arms out in front of you, bend the knees, transfer all your weight over to that left so you can slide that right foot out back behind you, shifting your weight. So not only are you feeling a stretch in the front of that left leg, you're also feeling the stretch in the foot. You're really working this quad. Breathe. Good job. Shifting the weight forward, bringing that right leg into the left. Arms come up and down. Last one. Bend into the legs. Shifting your weight onto the left foot leg. Reaching the right leg back. Really feeling that stretch, shifting the body. It's all about control and length. And shifting the weight forward, bring that left leg in to meet the right. I said the wrong legs, that's okay. Arms come down, good job. Let's face front. Let's march through our feet a little bit. Good. We're gonna make our way down to the ground. We're gonna do a little bit of some quad stretches since we just worked that quad. So we're gonna take a little bit of, I don't know what kind of pose this is. We're gonna take our right leg out in front of us. Our left leg is back behind us, our knees at a diagonal. We're gonna walk our hands back. You might already feel the stretch in that left leg already. Or we might have to press through the hip. So we're gonna press through our hip. So my hip is rotating towards the front. And I'm feeling a stretch all across the top of my quad. So yes, that muscle that we were just working to death in those little lunge poses, we're stretching that out. Exhale, lower that hip back down. And if you already feel the stretch here and you're sweating bullets just here stretching, then stay there. But if you could use a little bit more of a stretch, you're gonna follow me with the hips. So we're gonna press our hips forward. My hip bones are going forward. I'm already feeling that stretch. And bring the hip back. Let's do it again, pressing that hip bone forward. You can increase the stretch by bringing the heel into your butt a little bit more on that back leg. But still keeping that hip pressing forward. And relax that hip. Let's unwind that leg. Let's bring it out to the side at a diagonal. Toes up to the ceiling, knee up to the ceiling. Sitting up nice and tall. Feel your sit bones rooted equally into the ground. Adjust this leg, whatever feels comfortable. We're gonna lean on over to that left leg. And now rotate the body over the leg, facing the leg. Breathe into all these nooks and crannies. Good, and walk the hands up. Let's bring the soles of our feet together, sitting up nice and tall on our sit bones. Rock a little bit, make sure you find them. Sitting up nice and tall, feeling length in your spine. Let's roll the chin into the chest. Walk your hands out in front of you, really opening up these inner thighs again. Shake the head from right to left. Move the head around. Feel any stretch in the neck that needs to happen. Walking the hands up. Now we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So we're gonna bring that left leg out in front of us. Wrap that right knee back behind you so your knee is at a diagonal. And again, each side might feel different. So if you're already feeling a stretch here as you lean back into your hands, hang out here. If you need more, we're gonna press through that hip, bring that hip bone to the front of the room. Feel a stretch already through the front of the quad here. This leg is just supporting you. If you are really tight, you might feel some stretching, but we don't wanna feel any sharp pain in the knees. If it hurts your knees too much, just don't do this. You can stay in any of the other positions we did. Exhale, sink that hip back down. Let's press through the front of the hip again to the front of the room. And exhale, sink it back. If you need to increase the stretch, you can always bring that back heel in closer to your butt so that it makes it tighter. Inhale, press through the hip. Breathing. Exhale, sink that hip back. Unwind that leg. Let's bring it out to that diagonal, out to the side. Toes up to the ceiling. Adjust the front leg if you need. Walk that right hand out, up and over to the side. And turn the body, face the leg. Breathe into all the nooks and crannies. Inhale, walk the hands up. Let's bring the soles of the feet together. Once again, sitting up nice and tall on our sit bones, feeling length through our spine. Drop the chin into the chest, walk the hands out. Turn the head from right to left. Let's walk the hands over to the right. Walk the hands over to the left. Walk the hands to center and roll up through the spine. Let's arch the chest through the arms, lifting the head. Exhale, curving through the spine, making a nice C curve. Inhale, lifting the chest. Exhale, curving the spine. Inhale, lift. Exhale, curve. Sitting up nice and tall, let's bring our right hand to our left knee. Reach our left hand back behind us. Sit up nice and tall. Exhale, twist slightly. Inhale, lift. Exhale, twist. Last one. Inhale, lift. Exhale, twist. Unwind. Reaching that left hand to the right knee. Reach that right hand back. Inhale, sitting up tall. Exhale, twist. Inhale, sitting up nice and tall. Exhale, twist. Last one. Inhale for length. Exhale for twist. Come back to center. Let's bring our legs out in front of us. Give them a little shake. Open them at a slight diagonal. Give them a little shake. Rock our hips forward. Walk your hands forward. Shifting from side to side, opening the hips. Letting everything go, feel kind of noodly. Continuing to shimmy the shoulders. Bring your body up. You're all set, 15 minutes.